Sidechain compression. There's a better way to do it. The normal way to use sidechain compression is to take a compressor, sidechain the kick drum to that compressor, so everything ducks whenever the kick hits. This creates that pumping, pulsating sound that you hear in a lot of electronic music. And this is an effective way to accomplish this sound, but it's not the only way. What it's doing is actually compressing the sound, and you might be using other compressors, and so they can compete and it can become overly compressed. So the first step is to group everything that you want sidechained and make a new group and call it sidechain. Then on that group, add ShaperBox 2. Inside ShaperBox, click on volume, and then on the LFO mode, switch it from beats to hertz. And then the MIDI trigger, click on one shot, and bring the speed down to somewhere around 1.3. The speed is basically the attack and release of the compressor. Next, we will go ahead and make a new MIDI channel, and we can rename this to MIDI trigger. On this channel, on the all ins, change that to kick and select in right here. And then on the output, select the sidechain channel. Okay, one last thing we need to do in ShaperBox is give it a shape. So we can just select one of these pre-made shapes and see how that sounds. So basically what ShaperBox is doing is automating the volume every time the kick hits, and it makes it the volume automation go down and not an actual compressor compressing the sound. It's just lowering the volume. So let's just listen. And then we can hear when we change the speed of the hertz. That's like changing the attack and release. Okay, I noticed one thing wrong with my shape. Make sure at the end of it, you bring this all the way over, and so it starts high and it ends high. That way, it'll actually sound correct. I have my bass and a few synthesizers and guitar in the sidechain. We can really hear it pumping. Let's just throw in everything so you can really hear it. And if you don't want it super dramatic, you can also change the mix so it's a little bit lighter. You can also isolate which frequencies you want to sidechain. So if we only want the lows, we can move this kind of EQ and isolate that. To save this as a preset, just go down to this main menu here and go up to save, and then you can type in sidechain. And to load your preset, just go down to this open preset library, go over to my presets, and then you'll see all your presets. And that is my version of sidechain compression. I found that this method gives a nicer, cleaner, crisper sound to the sidechain. Also, Ableton's stock compressor tends to clip when you use it as a sidechain, so that's another reason that I don't like to use it. I know there are better compressor plugins out there like FabFilter that probably sound great using sidechain, but as an alternative to the stock Ableton compressor, I think ShaperBox is good. Cable Guys has a free, fully functional trial of ShaperBox, so you can give this a try for yourself. So yeah, I hope this was helpful, and let me know if there's a simpler, easier way to do this type of sidechain, maybe with a stock plugin or a free plugin. For now, this is my go-to method. Best of luck with your music making, and create every day.